change around you. You understand what I'm saying? Don't you leave nothing for the enemy to pick up because you don't know what you got or what God did. Check your surroundings. He said, would you be made whole? Now listen, when you come up to the altar and if God asks you what you want, don't you make no excuse, he went to saying, but when people come out, nobody else, the man of God, God himself, the living word, came down and he said, would you be made whole? Not just, would you be made whole? Do you want it? Because I'm going to give it all to you. That's why I heard he say made whole. Everything. You understand what I'm saying? God didn't do nothing halfway. You understand? God is a good God. God is a good God. He said some of you want miracles, but you're still complaining. You got too much excuses. And then he said, Chantel, you meet him in your prayer closet. And you get to praying. And God, I believe you. It's possible. And I know if you did this, you can do that. And I know if you did this. He said, but stop giving him directions and how he's going to give it to you. You understand? Because you're going to be astonished. Get up and shout and give God the glory. Give him the glory. You're about to get your breakthrough. In the name of Jesus, God is about to give it to you and anoint you and appoint you with it. And then it's not for everybody else because I'm not going to tell it all. But when you get through, he said, would you be made whole? You got some more things around you. You better check. You better check it out and see all what God has given you today. In the name of Jesus today. When you ask God for some, let him be God because he don't need your help. Some of you trying to help God. You want a miracle and you trying to help God do it. Whew. Carver said today, the other day, teaching, he tickled me, but he blessed my heart because it kind of sound like me sometimes. Anytime somebody say it ain't so, I say it is so. You know, it is so. Don't be telling me what God won't do and can't do. I don't want to hear it. Okay? Let God talk to me about that. He said you gotta have stupid faith. You understand what I'm saying? Isn't that what he said? You got to have that stupid faith. Now, I had to learn this too. It's all a learning process. When you got stupid faith, you cool. You cool. Because you riding on Jesus. You in rest. You in peace. Because you know that you know he gonna do it. And the enemy can't shake you. And you have no doubt. You just say it is. So whenever he do it, he gonna do it. I receive it. You cool. You understand? You're not worrying. You're not going back and picking it up. Stop trying to help God do the miracle because he is the miracle. You understand? Stop trying to help him do it. Be content. He had to tell me, be content. Where's your faith? It's the difference between hope and faith. Okay? But you say you got faith. And what the truth used to say, I can't tell. Okay? You say you have faith. Be at peace.
Yes.
Thank God. Get up and running and talking and skipping. I was out in the park the other day. I praise God because he's answering my prayer. He's doing a miracle. And he's working it out. He can do a supernatural thing and weight can just drop off. He can do that. But he wanted my health too. And he wanted me to persevere and endure. He wanted me to get up off my behind. Is what he wanted. And so I let him lead me and tell me how many times to jog around the park and how many times to walk and how many times to do my Pilates and I just let him do what he do best.
Yes, yes.
And the other day I was out there and I was running. All my body had been gave out. It just went out. And I got to that last little corner around there and go around again and I said, Lord, I can't do it. My body just ain't doing it. He said, one more time. I'm like, one more time. You know what? I ain't got one more in a time in this body. Right now, I just can't do it. These legs cannot carry this weight anymore, this body. You know? And I got there, and when I got there, I felt something extraordinary. Now, see, this is how you know it's God, because you ain't putting no effort in. You're not doing nothing. Literally. My legs up. And my legs got to going. And my arms got to, but you know what? It wasn't no stress. I wasn't doing nothing. dead weight. And you waiting on him. And you thanking him in the midst of all things. At all times. You understand?